Hello, Pythoneer. If you want to use the new flagship GPT-4.5 model from OpenAI in your Python project, then this video is for you. I will show you here how to get an API key and then the basic code you need to make your first API call with the stream function. Let's not waste any time and get straight into it. Head over to platform.openai.com/settings. If you don't have an account yet, you'll need to create one. Since the OpenAI API is pay-as-you-go, we have to manage our billing. On the left menu, under the Billing tab, we need to add a payment method and add some credit to your account. Next, we can create an API key under the API Keys tab. Press Create New Secret Key in the top right corner, give it a name, select a project, and press Create Secret Key. Then, copy the key and store it somewhere or paste it directly into your code editor. We'll need it soon. But before we get into coding, here's some additional info first. On the left, there's a Usage tab where you can see your API spending, and in the top right, there's a link to the docs. Here, we can, for example, get a brief overview of the models. We'll use the GPT-4.5 preview in this video. We can also have a look at the pricing, and well, that's why a lot of people are disappointed with OpenAI these days. As you can see, the shiny GPT-4.5 model is kind of expensive, with $75 for 1 million input tokens and $150 for 1 million output tokens. For comparison, the DeepSeek R1 reasoning model is currently at 55 cents per input and $2.19 for output tokens. That's a massive difference. Even compared to O3 Mini, which is only available for high-tier teams in the API, and the O1 model, which are way cheaper. How do you feel about this? Please let us know in the comments. But anyway, let's get into coding. We start by importing the OpenAI library with the OpenAI class and some error handlers. Then we install it using pip install OpenAI. To send a request to the model, we have to initialize the client with the OpenAI class, where we now pass our API key. Then we add a simple prompt variable, where we use the input function to ask the user for their question. With this setup, we can already create our request. I start by using a try statement, and we'll add the error handlers later below. Since we'll stream the output as an ongoing chat, I create a stream variable where I assign the result of the client.chatCompletions.create function from the OpenAI library. In here, we can define a lot of configurations. First, we set the model to the one we want to use. Here, I use the GPT-4.5 preview. Then we can pass the messages list we want to send to the model. The first part, with the role, system, is the system prompt I can give to the model to tell it how it should generally act, like I do here with act like a personal assistant. Second, we pass the prompt we grabbed from the input to the content of the role, user. The temperature affects the response of the model. The lower it is, the more it follows your instructions. The higher it is, the more creative the answer will be. The max tokens can limit your spending per request. 200 is very low, but as the model is this expensive, I try to keep its output as low as possible. If your response gets cut off, increase this value. Set the stream parameter to true so we get the response in chunks that we can display in blocks. To show these blocks as we get them, we use this code. We first say that as soon as we get a result in the stream, we print a response string to indicate the model's answer. Then we access the chunks out of the stream. If you don't know what the chunks mean here, write it in the comments and I'll try to explain. Here, we access the response by checking if unpacking the chunk using the chunk.choices0, delta.content attribute exists. We then use this in a print statement to visualize it as an ongoing print statement using the end parameter and flushing the text as soon as it's available by setting the flush parameter to true. To wrap this up, we now add error handlers for an authentication error, an API error, and an exception to catch possible errors. And that's it, basically. I'll add all links in the comments and in the GitHub repo so you can access them all. Then we can give it a run. As you see, we first get asked to enter a question in the terminal, and then we get the response as it's generated. And that's how it works. If you watched until here and you like it so far, please give it a like and subscribe. With minor changes, we can improve this to make it an endlessly running chat, but without history context in this example. If you're interested in this, let me know. I added a space after the user input to fix an issue here, and then wrapped the full code into an endless while loop. I also added an empty line in front of the user input to make it more readable. When we now run this, we see that we get the user input question, followed by a model output, and it loops directly back into the user input. The first question was, "How are you?" And the second was, "Tell me a joke." As you see, the model has no context awareness here. It just answers the direct question. And that's it. This is all I wanted to show you in this video. I hope this video helps you. If you enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a like and subscribe. On the left is first a video YouTube thinks you should watch, and then my latest one I suggest to you. Happy coding! I'll see you in the next one.